So in this video I'm going to do a tour of my craft room. I have been a little hesitant about filming this video just because I watch craft room tour videos all of the time on YouTube. They are my favourite thing to watch, and I know what people like tend to get mean comments about and stuff, so a couple of disclaimers before I start. I'll try and be quick because I know it's annoying when people ramble for like 10 minutes before they start things. So disclaimer the first. When I say a budget craft room, I freaking mean it, okay? So sometimes people say it's a budget craft room tour and then it's all beautiful matching furniture and beautiful matching storage, and you're just like, yes, it probably was a budget of a couple of grand. So yes, I mean cheap budget. I mean, none of the furniture in this room matches. I mean, I haven't spent anything. Well, I've spent maybe 50 quid on stuff in here, maybe. It's all stuff I already had, stuff that was already in this room, stuff that family members didn't want anymore, stuff I got for free, stuff I've repurposed, you know, things like that. So if you're into lots of matching, nice pretty furniture and everything looking beautiful, might not be the video for you. Disclaimer the second, it's not finished yet. And if you're wondering why are you doing it if it's not finished, why are you doing a tour now? Reason being is because some people have asked me to do it, so that's one reason. Secondly, it's not going to be finished for a long time. Basically, over there, which I'm not going to show you because it's gross, is a big structural problem. It's a nasty, nasty leak that's done a lot of damage. And it's going to take a long time to fix. You know, it's our big scaffolding job, and I'm up on like the third, it's actually like a third and a half floor up here. So yeah, that's going to take a long time to sort out. Like, we're talking 6 months to a year. And also because of that, the room isn't painted yet. So you'll probably be like, the worst paint job I've ever seen. The room's not painted yet because of, obviously we don't want to paint it before this problem is fixed. So it's not finished yet. That's why I'm doing it now. I'm also hoping to do like an updated tour in whenever it's finished, and I thought it might be quite interesting to show like the difference that's happened in that amount of time and how things change and how you sort of like change your crafting methods and stuff like that. So I thought that would be slightly interesting. Disclaimer the third is just quickly, sometimes people can get mean comments when they do these tours, like people being like, oh, you're just showing off all this stuff that you've got. I'm honestly not doing that. I'm doing it because I love watching them myself, so I just think it's a fun thing to watch. And to some people, I have naff all stuff anyway. To some people I'll have a medium amount of stuff, and to some people I have loads of stuff, you know, just it's all relative. And yeah, I've been doing this for a long, long time. Like, I've been into papercraft since I was a wee person, and I got my first planner like 10 years ago, so I've had a long time to accrue all this crap, and at the same time it's still not that much. Like, this room, I've still got plenty of space in this room to fill up. So there you go, there are your disclaimers, so please don't be mean to me, please. Right, so best get yourself a cuppa, or maybe like an entire thermos, because I think this is gonna take a while. So yes, settle yourself down and we'll get started.
I am currently standing in the dodgy corner of the room, just to give you a quick overview. As you can see the dodgy paint job up there. Just to give you a quick overview of what it looks like as a whole. Right, there you go. So, there you go, and I will start with my desk. So here is my desk. I have a love-hate relationship with this desk. My dad gave it to me when I started college, and yeah, it's massive. As you can see, it's like a meter deep. It's absolutely huge, which is a good thing, and I can store so much stuff in it. I can have all of this stuff on top of it and still have plenty of room to work. But at the same time, you know, it's not the prettiest of desks, but you know, it gets the job done. So we'll start up here, what I've got up the top, and then move down to the drawers. So starting here, you can just see a bit of the dodgy corner there, which I've covered up a lot with sheets. But this stuff is actually usually packed away in a drawer, but I just have a couple of scrap things here that I don't use for anything else, and I put like strips of washi, you know, when you get like little extra washi bits that you just need to throw away, like they all get put on there so I can throw away the whole piece of paper. I write notes, I test pens, you know, stuff like that. And then my memo pad I use all the time. I've got my cute little date thing there, which I got from New Look, actually, surprisingly enough. I really like that. And here is this carousel storage solution thingy. This is by Do Crafts or Paper Mania, whichever you want to say. And I picked this up in the range for, I think it was about £10. So it has, as you can see, six of these little tubs. Whoop. And three of these longer ones. Now, they do actually come with lids, so you can keep stuff with lid on if you want to, but I put the lids at the bottom so I can use them as pen pots. So in here, going round, in this one I keep all of my fine gel pens, you know, those 0.38mm ones. I love these pens so much. They are my favourite pens to use in planners, and I'm building up quite a collection of different types just because I absolutely love them. So they all go in there. This one here has got various things that are just basically frequently used. So I've got mechanical pencils, which I use a lot, my V-pen fountain pens, the black Sharpie, a couple of biros, just stuff like that, and my Lamy as well. And then in here, the bottom one has pins in, and this top one has all my metallic and sparkly type pens and like my white rollerball. Use that constantly. This next section here, the lower part has spare ink cartridges in, and this one has other frequently used pens. So there's more biros in here, more mechanical pencils, another Sharpie, coloured biros as well, just loads of different bits like that. And then obviously in these two ones I keep like functional things. That's a little notepad that I put like dimensions of stuff in, like certain cards I make, I just jot down the dimensions and things because I can't be bothered to remember them, so that's what's in there. I've got my big scissors, my craft knife, my crochet needle, which I use for poking holes in things. Then this little one here has got little scissors and a razor, and I've got these two of these. One's got, this is the pointy one, there's another one with a more flat end. Sparkly tweezers, which I got from Primark, very helpful for picking up, you know, like really teeny tiny stickers. And there's also some hair grips in there. I'm not quite sure why, but there are. Oh, and underneath is full of sweeties in case I need, you know, an emergency sugar. And then up in the middle there as well is my rulers. So I've got my metal one that I use for scoring, and some plastic ones for, you know, measuring, what rulers are for. Down here is my little cow buddy who guards my lamp, which I can't really show you without showing you the dodgy corner too well. I'm just sort of, ooh. There's my lamp there. It's a daylight lamp, I think. That was in my dad's office and he wasn't using it, so I was like, it's mine now. So up here, this is one of the only bits of actual furniture I have bought for this room. This idea, I think, was originally Daisy from My Green Cow came up with this, and now like everyone does it. It's this white shoe rack from Argos that costs like £10 to £12. And yeah, you just put it up the top of your desk for some like some extra shelves. Most people in these shelves have these IKEA baskets, which I think apparently fit perfectly, but I didn't want to spend the money, and most of the stuff on there I already had, so that's why I didn't buy those things. So if we start from the bottom to the top, these three drawers, I'm going to get them, well, not drawers, boxes that act as drawers, I'll get them out at once. These house all of my ephemera. So in this one is all like little pieces of ephemera, or ones where I've used so much of the pack that there's no point in keeping the whole pack together. And look, there's these things at the front, which are like mini Project Life cards. So here, stuff, just little bits and bobs in here, and like things I've punched out with my craft punches, live in here as well. So there's all sorts of little things in there. This one holds the slightly smaller packs of ephemera, so for the most of this, all my simple stories, bits and pieces ones. I've got two of the Carpe Diem ones because I loved it so much. These ones at the back, these are ephemera packs that come in like blister packs. So because I store my ephemera in the bag that it comes in, when you have a blister pack, you can't do that. So I've put them in these sealable bags, and then I put the label from the pack itself and glue it onto the bag so I know which one it is. So that's not the best example of that. Let me find one of the others. Like that one, I've cut out what was on the back of the pack and glued it on there, so I know exactly what's in there. And a couple of other bits, I've got a little rainbow moon pack and a paper chase pack there. And this slightly bigger box, I think I got from Sainsbury's ages and ages ago, so I don't think they do them anymore. Or these two were from Wilco, but also ages ago, so I don't know if they still do them. But in here are just the larger packs of ephemera. So as I said, I keep them in the packs just so I know what's what. These are all the bigger ones, and also down here somewhere I've got these longer ones. These come in these Mambi kits where you get like big project life cards and little ones and mini ones, and then a load of ephemera. So like, those chill out in there as well because they're quite long. And this is the lid of a box which you will see at some point eventually, and I've just used this as a sort of drawer for my useful bits and bobs. So glue sticks, glue runner, my Repesco punch, more glue, stapler, some Tippex, sellotape, measuring tape, more glue runners, hole punch and glue dots, and a spare thing of sellotape as well. So that's just so it can be really, really handy. And I use the things I use most often, like the glue sticks and the Repesco, are up at the front so I can reach them nice and easy. This little storage box doodad here I will bring out. This again was from Wilco ages and ages ago. This was £3 or £4 when I bought it. It's coming on a year old, this one, I think. In here, the first drawer kind of has miscellaneous for useful bits, so, well, that looks quite a mess. Just like hemp string, some pins, some foam adhesive things, some magnetic strips. What else is in there? I've got a spare blade for my paper trimmer, just random stuff. That one. This one has charms that I'm not using at the moment, or you know, I'm going to use eventually. Just loads of planner charms and stuff that I'm not using, or that I'm going to put up on my vision board once it's ready. Just stuff like that. And this drawer also has ephemera in, and this is ephemera usually that people have sent me, so I don't have like enough of it to have for it to like have its own little bag in collections and things, and so they just all kind of hang out in there, and I know where like miscellaneous ephemera is in there. In these two boxes, I've just taken the lid off this top one because it's hard to get off with one hand. This little box was from Wilco. In this I keep stickers, like just loose miscellaneous stickers that are just ready to send in happy mail to people. You know, they're just like in little groupings and stuff. Most often they're cut-offs from kits that I haven't used all of, and just things that I think people might appreciate, might get some use out of, because I don't think I'm going to use them. So loads and loads of bits that I'm going to send to people in there. And then this box, which I got from TK Maxx for a couple of quid. I love the colour. This one, if I can get the lid off, there we go. This one is kind of the opposite. So this is stickers that people have sent me, miscellaneous ones that I'm going to use. So I just have to remember whenever I'm doing anything, I usually give this like a good route through to find things. And like, I have this big bag here that I got in a giveaway, cut off from a shop, and just loads of bits and bobs in there that people have sent me. Next, I won't reach it, is this wrap pencil case thing, and in here I keep my calligraphy pen. So these are all like felt tipped calligraphy pens, and these are the fountain ones, so I just keep them all together in there ready for use. And then these two little baskets were from Poundland. It was a pound for both of them. And these are empty, and they are meant to be empty, apart from apparently a dirty mark in that one. These are for if I'm in the middle of a project, I put stuff in these things so they don't get all over my desk and I don't lose them. So say I'm doing a project where I wanted things that were purple and I wanted to find things that were bird related, I go through all of my ephemera and all of my stickers and put them in these boxes ready so that when I'm midway through I can just flick through here and be like, oh, there's that thing matches perfectly, that thing matches perfectly. In the end I pack it all away again just so I don't have to keep rooting through like all of that ephemera every time I need to do something. So that's what those are there for. Right, and pretty much the rest of the desk is devoted to stickers. I'll just show you this here. It's got this little notice board that I backed with some fabric and put some just positive quotes and stuff on. But yes, down here, on the top here, I should say, move these out the way. So these two boxes here were actually originally GHD boxes, or just one GHD box. One's the lid and one's the bottom. I can't remember which one's which because one's deeper. So they got covered in wrapping paper. I didn't do it myself because I suck so bad at wrapping. I got someone to do it for me very kindly. So I put like really thick, sturdy wrapping paper on, you know, like the expensive stuff you buy in sheets rather than rolls. And these store my big stickers. So these are like the big sticker packs like this. Like Mambi ones and my Star Wars pack and long like 12 inch ones like this. You might recognise some of these from Brimble's boxes that I haven't got around to using yet because I'm so behind in my scrapbooking. And this one has all my Alpha stickers in and I have an insane amount of Alpha stickers. Like, it is getting ridiculous. It really, really is. And just go forever. Just so many. And then there's a load down there which you can't see so well, and then there's a load of there and stickers and stuff like that. So yeah, there's just loads and loads of Alpha stickers there. Just quickly, these little fellas here were both like just little gifts from people that, you know, these like little novelty erasers which I will never use because they're too cute. Got my beautiful clip from Kiki K, that lovely vase there was just a gift from someone, and in these three little basket type things, these three were from the range, and it was a pound for all three. I go to the range all the time and they don't have any white ones in at the moment. They haven't for a while. They have black ones and they have multicolored ones, but haven't seen white ones there for a while, I'm afraid. But in here I keep kind of loose stickers and sticker flakes and stuff like that. So I've got like these little packs. It's a floral one and the rest are all cat related ones that you order from like AliExpress and places like that. So loads of little cat sticker flakes and stuff in there. More sticker flakes in here. These are from my friend Gemma. She sent those to me. I think she sent me all of the ones in here, actually, come to think of it. And this one holds the masking sticker sets. Oh, I keep putting my finger over the lens, I'm so sorry. I'm just so used to using a tripod. Some more sticker flakes, which I should really put in that one. And then these boxes, which are label stickers. You can sort of see on the bottom there what's in there. These are kind of things I got from eBay or AliExpress or something like that. And all of these folders are all stickers, so those are all random decorative ones. Basically that one's decorative stickers that aren't related to Etsy. Those are functional Etsy stickers, those are decorative Etsy stickers, those are Etsy sticker like weekly kits, those are kit leftovers and also kits for personal size. This little folder, which was from the UKPA Big Meat Booty Bag, if I can get the clip off with one hand, there we go. This is where I keep all my samplers and stuff. And the big folder there I use for printables. So I'm not, as you see, I'm not going into those in detail. If anyone would like me to do a sticker storage and collection video, then let me know and I will. But if I do it now, then this video will be approximately 4 hours long. So in this beautiful drawer unit, it's a wooden drawer unit I got as a Christmas present last year, but I'm pretty sure it's from the range for about 15 or 20 quid. This is where I keep spare stickers as well. So in there is labels and whole reinforcements and dots and stuff. That one, this is one where these stickers are all discontinued. So once they're used, they're gone. This one has the ones that I order from like eBay. So these cute cat ones and those heart stickers and stuff like that. And the top has stickers from Hamer. Then down here, these are both sort of like in trays, to-do boxes. So this one is my main in tray, stuff I need to sort out. So there's some things I've bought that I need to put away. Those some things I want to remember to use. Some dividers I've just laminated ready to go into a new planner. You know, stuff I need to sort out basically. And this one, oh, that tray was from Tiger. This was from TK Maxx, but I'm pretty sure you can get them in the range as well. It would cost a quid or so. And there were some sweets in there because they were too big to go in my other little sweetie compartment. Got my earphones. And there's only two things in here right now, but these are things I'm starting to collect for my vision board. So I'm just starting, when I see things I want to put on it, I'm just throwing them in there. So next I will go through my drawers. So you see there's quite a few of them. So I'll start from the bottom here and then go around the, that bottom there. So the first drawer is very, very unexciting. This is all photos I need stuff to do with, and it's all my important documents as well, like insurance info and really dull stuff like that. This one, I'm not really a stamper at all, something I haven't really got into yet. So I only really have like a small selection of wooden stamps and a couple of these roller stamps or whatever they're called. So there's just a small selection of stamps. This box is the one where the lid is over there. And this box was from Sainsbury's like over 2 years ago, but it's a good box, it's held up well. Down here I've got like ink pads and stuff. I've got some staplers there for some reason. They should be elsewhere. And I've got the wax seal stamps as well, because you know, stamps in the name. This drawer doesn't have much in it because it's full of stuff that I always want to just grab really quickly, like a blue tack. It's my Fiskars paper trimmer, so I just like to be able to just grab it quickly. And my We Are Memory Keepers 1-2-3 punch board, and I've just got all my craft punches and stuff down here, and my corner punches as well. So just handy tool stuff that doesn't really have a space on the desk, and I can just grab quickly from this drawer. This drawer is a ridiculous drawer, quite frankly. This entire drawer is devoted to paper clips. I have a serious problem, as you can see. Like, this is just ridiculous. So that's just the lid of a shoebox, and that holds all like the loose paper clips and stuff. I do rotate my paper clips around all the time as well, so just in case, like, you've sent your person, like, one of my Happy Mail buddies, and you've sent me one of these, and you're like, oh, you shouldn't be using the clip I sent her. I rotate them around all the time, so some, half of these have, like, definitely been used, and some of them are about to be used, so, yes. And then back here, paper clips that are in boxes and stuff, so these are just boring ones that I use for, you know, like, actual paperclip purposes. This is my second pack of these rose gold ones from Paper Chase. Just lots and lots of ones in packs and boxes. This back here, again, lots of different paper clips in there and binder clips. This is from the tool section in Wilco. It cost me about 70 pence for that. Pretty good price. But yeah, this entire drawer is for paper clips, which I'll admit is ridiculous. Then the big wide drawer here is my washi drawer. Pull this out as far as we can. There we go. So what I want to do with this drawer eventually is actually just have wooden slats made, someone to cut them up for me, just to have them simply divided up like that. But at the moment, as you can see, I'm using cutlery drawers. That one looks fine because it's a wooden one, so it looks all right, but this plastic one is like seriously ugly in this drawer. I hate it, but it's doing the job for now. So yeah, in here you can see I've got like all my blacks and whites, florals go here, and watercolory ones and metallic ones and brownish ones, glittery ones there, cat ones there, and then they're like divided up by, oh, that one's falling over. All right, buddy. Divided up by colour there. Down here is all the wide washi. This box here, which as you can see used to have postcards in, this is where I keep things like sellotape, like patterned sellotape and double-sided tape and tape that's not washi, basically. But this solution is going to last like a week more because I've just ordered a whole load of washi from AliExpress and I don't know where to put it, so I need to sort out this storage option very, very soon. In this drawer is another washi drawer. So this has got all the skinny washi here and slim washi and more skinny, you know, super skinny, skinny, slim, and more slims up here, and a couple of bits and bobs, like some fabric tape I have, and one of these runner things. Here I have all my washi samples that people send me, and a load of spare washi tapes as well, and washi that like I can put in Happy Mail as well. These little boxes are actually drawers of one of those like cardboard gift drawer units. You'll see the actual unit itself in a minute. This drawer is my embellishments drawer. So these actually need to go elsewhere. I need to put those up in my in tray because I have another home for those. But yeah, so in here I've got all various embellishments. So there's sort of a pile of medium-sized packs here. All my large packs get stuffed there. Enamel dots tend to hide down here. I don't have very many of those. And then smaller packs there. And then this black box. This had a paper tape planner in it, actually. Very, very handy little box. This has my most frequently used stuff, so like my pearls and like little diamante ones, also some loose flowery bits and things that have like fallen off, like this fell off a flip book somebody sent me, but I had to keep it because it was so cute. So yes, lots of little bits and pieces in there. And this last drawer, it's actually, it looks like two drawers, but it's one really deep drawer, so I'm going to pull the stuff that's in here out, actually, because I think it's gonna be quite hard to show you what's inside with me trying to reach into it. So this first thing here, this is another one of those drawers, and this one has various sticky notes, so little packs of sticky notes and stuff. These were actually quite neatly piled at one point, but clearly they've suffered the wrath of me pulling out drawers too quickly. So lots of sticky notes and page flags and stuff like that in here, loads and loads of little bits. And then this one, I'm probably going to need two hands to pull this out, so hang on. So this is the actual main part of that drawer unit I was telling you about. So I took the drawers out for other storage and I've used this as like to keep little compartments and things. So here is more sticky notes. These are the slightly bigger ones or longer ones, with these little mini list pads from Hamer. This little section is all list pads, so these all live in here. I do love my list pads. They're great to like punch and put in your planners and stuff and just generally look very pretty. This long section here has sticky note booklets. So if I just open one, so booklets like that, just full of the same kind of sticky note patterns. So they all hang out in there, and also in there I've got some more list pad papers that won't really fit in here, and they're also the loose ones which are actually clipped together somewhere. And in this back compartment, these are all empty notebooks waiting to be filled at some point, so I can put them in my TNs and stuff. So various ones, these ones I cut down to fit into TNs. So yeah, that's what's in there, spare notebook storage. There was my desk. I just thought, just in case anyone is curious, that's my chair. I bought that last year from Fleabay for 30 quid or so, because the chair that came in my student house was like this rubbishy plasticky thing and I was not having that. So that's a chair and a little pillow for my back. So moving around here, it gets pretty dark in this corner, so I'm really sorry if the lighting is a bit naff. Yeah, this corner has no light really reaching it at all, but yeah, down there is bin. I've got a heater because it can get very friggin' cold in this room. There's the old British classic, a bag of plastic bags. These two things here, there's quite a funny story behind these. They were IKEA lac tables, you know, just this really short little coffee tables, which I had up in Nottingham. But the reason they're like this is because they were stored at someone's house for a week before they came down to my place in Kent. And the person left the legs at their house and only brought me the tables. So yeah, that's why they're there. But they're actually fairly useful for like video backgrounds and doing pictures and stuff. So, and I haven't got the room in here to have them as tables. So probably a blessing, really. This here is a built-in wardrobe, which I'm not going to show you because I do not use it for anything crafty. So in there, I keep all my like out-of-season clothes and stuff. So there's no point in opening that to show you. And here, I have my one piece of IKEA furniture in the entire room. This was in my dad's office or one of his work rooms or something, and there was just a couple of bits on it and I was like, Dad, are you really using that? And he was like, well, not really. And I'm like, can I have it? So yeah, that's how I managed to get hold of that. I'm not really utilising it very well at the moment. I don't have the stuff to fill it right now, to be honest, so it's ready and waiting to be properly filled, so no need to moan that I'm not utilising it very well. I'm aware of this. So at the top here is a family photo, is my Kiki K bag, because I can't bear to get rid of it. This cat ornament here, I got in Sainsbury's like a week after Halloween for like £2, yay! In this compartment, there's just this cute box with some family photos and a candle and my cat mirror, so you'll see me. Hello. Oh no, that was dumb. Hello. My cat mirror. I love my cat mirror. It needs a better home, but it needs properly fixing. This compartment here has got my Kiki K collection, my very, very small and growing Kiki K collection. That's not even anything, that's just the box because it looks pretty, but you know, paper lovers, books and the printed notepads and postcards and stuff. My love affair with Kiki K is only just beginning, so this will hopefully be very full at some point. And here, which is very dark, I have to sort of try and stand out the way so I don't get shadows. I've got my skull ornament, which like sort of matches the cat one. That was from TK Maxx for a fiver or so. Just got some little shells down there because I live by the sea, so naturally shells accrue around. Here I've got my scrapbook. That's a notepad or a notebook that I'm going to dismantle to use the papers inside. You'll see what I mean later. That is my old recipe binder, which I need to transfer the recipes in there into my new recipe binder. And down there is my old quote book, which I need to transfer the quotes into my new quote book. Here, I'm going to get down on the floor to show you this. Ooh, so hopefully there's not too much of a shadow. So this is one of the other few things I've actually bought for this room. I saw this in the range and I just really, really, really wanted it. It cost me less than a tenner, so it's not bad. And I have my little Daryl Dixon guarding it there. Just move him out the way. So in here is mostly sequins. So at the top row here we've got various, that's like a sorted black and white ones, silver ones, big silver ones. Got my Halloween ones there, which really need to go into my Halloween folder, but I haven't got anything to fill that one up yet, so when I have something to fill it, I'll get rid of the Halloween ones. These are also Halloween ones, but I'm going to keep them around all year because it's skulls, cats and bats, three of my favorite things. Don't care if it's Halloween or not. Those are large circle sequins. Those are weird shapes, like assorted things. You've got these little pearl things that I use for photo backgrounds. There's also these little, this is a various pack of like shiny pretty things, also for photo backgrounds. Just got all these loose little flowers. I've got a little diamante in the middle of each one. These are punch outs from my mini punches. Like, I never waste any paper at all, so like scrap paper gets little bits of it gets punched by big punches and the little bits get punched by little punches. And I usually put into Happy Mail or something, just, you know, someone opens it and gets covered in them. Ha ha. Silver brads, gold brads, multicoloured brads, and then these are some flowers, just embellishment things. Really they should be in the embellishments drawer, but their bag broke, so they're living in there for now. In here, there's not much, and I know it's facing the wrong way, but I like to be able to see it when I'm sitting at my desk. But I have a couple of colouring books, and like this book has got like loads of pretty pictures that I can cut out, and like some crafty stuff, and there's some manuals and stuff back there.
This one, get on the floor. Ugh.
This one has notebooks, like the pretty notebooks that are waiting to be filled. So I have like my Hobbit Moleskine, and look, it's got the thing on the side, which is the same as my tattoo. Woo! And Smaug the Dragon, which is the same as my other tattoo. Because I've got a House Targaryen Game of Thrones one, just like my really, really pretty ones that are ready to be filled. This was a gift ages and ages ago, and it's a Chinese calligraphy set, but it's just, it's too pretty to use, so it's very, very much an ornament.
Down in here, this is very boring, this one, but this is basically just spares of stuff. So in here I have spares of pens that I use frequently. Let's see if I can actually open this.
So like these cat pens, which I use all the time, not just because of the cats, but because I really like the nib. I buy them in bulk, so all the spares are in there.
And this is also spares of things like glue and sequins and pins, and just very, very dull. Pencil cases here that I'm not using at the moment. And in there, if I try and get some light going on there in our little dark corner here, is just some folders that I'm also not using right now. This, if the camera would feel like focusing, no, maybe not, okay, well, you can see it well enough, but that is a laundry bin. I'll give it to you, but I actually use it for paper recycling. If I can get out of the way, you can see just some paper at the bottom there. Because I throw away so much paper, even though I try and like conserve it by punching stuff and that, I still throw away so much, so I'll have it all in there and then recycle it when the time comes. And the fact that it's got a little handle is very handy, because usually you can just slip things in there. So next I'm going to be showing you this section here, the stuff that's like directly behind my desk that I can just like reach backwards and grab. So starting over here, you probably hear my chair because I'm sat on it because I'm really, really lazy. This here, I have a funny story behind this one actually. This very nice sort of cute shelving unit. It's a proper good piece of furniture actually. It's like proper solid wood. my mum was using it as a shoe rack in our hallway. And while I was in the very early stages of doing this room and desperate to find some way to store my 12 by 12 papers, and couldn't think of anything without spending a fortune on like one of the official shelving units, you know, that are 12 by 12, I was walking through the hallway and I looked at that and I went, that looks about 12 inches wide. And then I was like, Mum, how attached are you to that shelving unit? So that's how it ended up in here. So in here, there's my tripod just living in the corner down there. These are actually little baggies that we had as bridesmaids for my friend's wedding very recently. I accidentally took two of them back with me, but none of the bridesmaids have claimed the other one, so I've got two. Up the top, I have these 6x12 paper pads up here, which I've shown in a haul video before. This first shelf has all my 6x6 paper and cardstock packs. So there's all of those. And there's an A5 one there as well. And then on this side are all these sort of A5 size ones that you get from Poundland, which I love because they're so cheap. And there's a A4 Santoro gorgeous one there. So the next shelf has all the sort of pretty, summery and very colourful paper pads, or cardstock pads I should say actually, up there. That one obviously is not 12 by 12, but it fits in there anyway. The next one down is all the darker colours. So I've got the craft pad, I've got a vintage pad, I've got a black and
white pad, another vintage pad, and another vintage pad, and a Santoro gorgeous pad. And down the bottom here are all my paper packs. So everything up there really was cardstock, and then these are all the ones that are little paper packs, and I also keep all my loose papers as well in here, so they all hang out down there. Down the side here is a Star Wars bag that has bags in, basically. So I've got like organza bags, and let me see if I can find like a pack of, there's a couple of packs of these craft storage bags, just loads of stuff like that, Ziploc bags and stuff. They're really useful for Happy Mail and storing crafty bits, so just hang out down there. Down in this corner, which you really can't see because it's very, very dark, I'm very sorry. This is my Halloween folder, which obviously I've now put everything away because Halloween is done for the year, sad face. And then in this basket, which was actually, this might be too much information, but in my postgrad student room last year, there was no drawers, there was only a wardrobe. So I had nowhere to put my underwear, quite frankly. So I bought this from Amazon for about £10 or £15 to put my, you know, my pants and my socks and things in there. But I don't need it anymore. So now it houses some fabrics. These are adhesive fabrics. And I've got all my tissue papers in here. And there's some stray stickers. I'll talk about those in a second. And some more fabrics and felts. And just some wrapping paper. That kind of stuff. And then at the back here, I've also got extra stickers. So I have bajillions of these packs from the range. So these are all stickers that I've already got in my storage, but I bought multiples of because I will use them. So that's where they hang out. This little section here is mostly stuff for scrapping, apart from this, which houses all my labels, like pretty labels, you know, things like this. So pretty labels live in there. Oh, and also paper doilies live in there as well. So that's what's in there. This box, probably from TK Maxx, but I've had it for ages. I can't really remember. This box is also from TK Maxx, which I've had for ages, or may have even been a gift, but that's full of stuff that I need to scrap or, you know, junk journal. As are these two bags of things, but these are like for specific things, like that stuff I need to scrap for one particular event, and that's what stuff I need to scrap for another event. So I just keep them in little separate baggies so they don't get lost among, you know, the nightmare that's in there. This shelf, as you can see, is very empty at the moment, so it has a lot of potential. Here I have paper packs that are not just paper. So things that also have die cuts, and these are ones I've shown on my YouTube channel before. These have vellum and stickers and loads of stuff in. So they go there, and there's some other ones here. There's like one that's got cats and some Santoro ones. So basically paper packs that aren't just paper. Then I have my cutting mat here. I'm hoping for a new one though, because this is just getting, this is secondhand to me. So I really want a new one at Christmas. I've got some A3 white card there, because this was like half the price of the 12x12. And I very rarely do anything that's exactly 12x12, so I bought that instead of a 12x12 pack. Up this top shelf here, if you saw my last video like this, my desktop video from about 10 months ago or so, this is where I store scraps of paper. So this is all big scraps, like sort of anything that's of a decent, basically anything that doesn't fit in there, scraps go in here. So I often root through this to find something useful. And then this one, as I said, has got all the little scraps as well. As I frequently have said in this video, nothing goes to waste around here. This is another one of those little baskets from TK Maxx, and this has got all my ribbons and stuff in. I'm not really a ribbon type person, so I haven't got very much. And then all of this here, which I probably, no, I'm not going to go into because it's just too much, and this is all my Christmas stuff. So that's, this box is absolutely full of Christmas stuff, and there's Christmas paper pads there and some foil paper there as well. So if anyone would like me to go through my Christmas stuff before Christmas, like my big Christmas craft box, then I will, but for now I'm not going to do it because it's just going to take ages. And when Christmas is over, this entire section of Christmas stuff will go over there in that cupboard until it's needed again in, you know, October time 2017. Up the top here, there's not too much. Actually, I'll just say about this, this is, the whole unit is one thing. I have no idea where this came from. It was already in the room, so it's probably been here since the Stone Age. I don't know where it's from. I am considering painting it white, but I think that will be quite a job because it's so dark and this is glossy as well, that yeah, it might be quite an effort. I need to consult a furniture painting expert on that. So there, I've just got some little trinkets. These are these cute little cat pens. The black one was from my mum, and the blue, the turquoise one, was from my friend Gemma. There's my photo frame because my cat is just the love of my life. This is from my friend's wedding. This, they had the centerpieces in these, and she gave me one for some work, you know, because I'd helped her a lot with some stuff. I want a bigger arrangement of faux flowers in here, but for now, these little cheapy ones will do. And I've got my poppies in here as well, just for November. Then I've got my cat bookends, which I love so much. These are big, sturdy, like, I don't know what the material is. It's like marble-esque. I love these. They were a gift, so I can't tell you how much they were. And all along here is all my, like, planners in use and notebooks in use. So starting from the end, I've got my reckless journal, my journal, my quote journal. These two, I've done things like Lister's Got a List and stuff like that in there. Things that, like, projects that have been started and never quite achieved. That's the recipe per folder I was telling you about that I need to move everything into. That is a study book. That is an empty traveler's notebook. Those are my two Lyra Dories. That one's for study notes. And that one's got an art journal in it that I've only recently started, because you can just see there's not much time there. This is empty for now. This was in the UK PA Big Meat goodie bag. I'm going to use that just for insert storage. I use pocket. It keeps spare pocket inserts in there. These two are both Metropoles. There's a lavender Metropole and a black Metropole. They have like last year's personal inserts and stuff like that in. That is my Kingfisher Blue Metropole. It on there, in there, sorry. I do like a mini journal, kind of like a couple of lines a day. I do it on week on 2 pages insert, so it's like a couple of lines per day journal in there. There is my Webster's Pages white colour crush, and that's my Christmas planner. That is my Filofax A5 clip book, which I just store inserts in. That is my Paper Chase A5, which hasn't been set up yet. I'm going to make that a pen pal planner. Pen pal planner, pen pal, say that 10 times fast. There's all my turquoise dominoes. The pocket is not currently in use. That is my everyday planner. That is my A5, which hopefully in the next couple of weeks when I have the time, all of that is going to be put into the new Kiki K. And this red Metropole here is my home planner. So, you know, insurance details, address book, cleaning schedules, you know, really, really dull stuff like that. The stuff that's in there will probably actually end up in there once that stuff gets moved into there. Am I making any sense? Here is another one of those like gift boxes that you get at Christmas. And you can probably still, I've left the sticker on, goodness me, I've had this for ages, still got the sticker on, like it says what it had inside it originally. But yeah, in here I have, in these drawers, have gift bags, like mini gift bags that are really for scrapbooking more than anything else. So those are in there. And in this drawer, if I can open it, I keep these revision card sets, but these pretty ones that I've got from Wilko, they're just really good for, you know, happy mail, journaling, all sorts of stuff. And up here, which is looking quite messy at the moment because I've knocked it, is where I store all my Project Life and journaling cards. If I go from above, you can appreciate it a little bit better, I think, than it looks from the front. And I've still got a bit of space to use up, which I'm just filling with these little mini folders. So I've got a little cat set there. And then here, so they're all divided by theme, really. Mrs. Brimble's postcards, speciality, foiled, glitter, functional, things that are like related to the months and weeks and days, words and titles,
quote cards. And then decorative is, I've got subheaders of patterned. What does that say? Oh, inked rose. I'm going inked. Inked rose. Images. Floral. And vintage. Yeah, I've got my little rainbow moon cards, which haven't been had. Bless them, they haven't got a little title card yet. It's Crafty Alley ones in there. The Project Life High Five set. Carpe Diem ones. The Manby Family set. The Manby Snapshot set. Project Life Inked Rose again. Project Life Forever Young. Frames that came in the inked rose. And then back there as well. This is really hard to do with one hand, actually. Is Webster's pages. And I keep all the Webster's pages together there. And then as for the standard size, we have Mrs. Brimble's there, but she's lost her. Oh, there it is. Mrs. Brimble's ones, speciality, glitter, quotes and words. I'm just about to see down there. Glitter decorative, foiled quotes and words, foiled decorative, functional, and then stuff that's related to months, weeks and days. Words and titles, stuff like that. Hello sunshine, hello today, stuff like that. Quotes, I love quote cards. Just so I've got a ton of those. Symbols, things like ampersands and stuff like that. And then again, decorative is subheaded. Well done on your words there, Grace. So patterned, which I've got a ton of. Floral, images. And vintage back there. The reason I've got so many vintage ones is because I bought one of those massive Project Life core kits. So where there's, you know, best part of 200 cards or whatever in those. So that's why I've got so many vintage themed ones.
Right, we are starting to lose the light, so I'm gonna have to get a wiggle on. But so this half of the big shelving unit is pretty much all of it, apart from one box devoted to Happy Mail. So be suitably impressed. So this is another one of those boxes I got from TK Maxx, and as I think I said earlier, you can get them in the range as well. This is all Happy Mail that I need to reply to, so it's like a Happy Mail in tray. You see I'm a little bit behind, I've got a ton to reply to. I keep both flip books and letters that I need to reply to in there. This little box is another one that I got from Sainsbury's ages and ages ago. I really don't think they do them anymore, I'm afraid. All these little bags are stuff for pen pals that I've put aside for like particular people, so that's what all the stuff in there is like, so I know who each bag is for. Not every pen pal has one of these bags, because not every pen pal I send stuff to, some people are just letters. But yes, so that's what all those little bags are. So in each of these bags is something for someone. Ooh, that's just my Kilner jar, which I use for my change jar. Pretty self-explanatory. Here, I'm quite proud of this for absolutely no particular reason. These are these writing sets from The Range that look like this. And I absolutely love them. So I think I have every colour that they do. I think there was a massive pile. Did I say The Range or The Works? They're from The Works. I can't remember. Going mad. They had a massive pile in my local one, and I went through and I got every single colour that I didn't already have. And some of the ones I particularly like, I got two. And every time I go in The Works, I actually think they're starting to discontinue them now, which is, you know, sad face. But yeah, if I see a colour that I don't have, I just buy it, no questions asked. But I think I've got every colour, I'm not sure. But yeah, so there's those, which are, yes, I'll admit they're ridiculous. So down here on this next shelf, I've got a couple of boxes. I'm going to bring them out actually to show you, because hopefully the lighting will be better. This, because of the colour of this unit, it does sort of suck in all the light. It is quite dark over here. That's very heavy. So in here, I have planet inserts and stuff like that. So I've got some dashboards there, some inserts that came in the goodie bag. There's like, I made a template for dividers, and there's like functional stuff in there, like rulers and like plastic pockets and stuff. That is personal size notepaper, and this one and that and that are all A5 size notepaper, and the rest of those little folders are empty, waiting for me to finally get around to. As many of you know who are frequent viewers of my channel, I make my own planner inserts, but I'm a nightmare for like pre-printing them. I just kind of print off a couple as and when needed. I really need to just print a load of them, quite frankly. There's also some tabs in here and stuff like that. What's down there? Well, that is a massive wad of budget planner inserts. Oh, that's gonna fall down. I'm just gonna let it. That someone sent me when I bought a secondhand planner. If anyone wants these, let me know, because I'm never gonna use them. So that's what's in there. And there's also, like, this was a notebook that I dismantled. It's just now a handy folder for keeping bits and bobs in. That pencil tin there currently just has highlighters in. Very, very boring. I won't go into it. And then that box there. Oh, that box was from Wilko, by the way, as was this one. But that was the cheap £2 one, which, as you see, is a bit... And that is the £3 or £4 one, which is much, much, much sturdier. So definitely go for those, because they're just way better. This is all envelopes. I'm not going to bother getting it out. There's just a ton of different sizes and styles. All at the back are like, there's like a load of C5 ones there, and greeting card, standard greeting card size ones there. There's just a ton in there. And then I've got all my Jiffy bags and stuff there, and some hardback envelopes. And then these are all those like stripy gift bags. My mum came across them in her office / packing room, and she doesn't use them, so she's like, do you want them? Why not? So beware, pen pals, you will be getting stuff in stripy gift bags. So on this bottom shelf, starting from the right here, this accordion or concertina file, or whichever you wish to call it, is pen pal letter storage. So once I've replied to something that's in there, it goes in here, and each pen pal has their own little section, and I just keep the last couple of letters, like between 3 to 6 letters of theirs, in here. And then once it's more than 6 or so, they will then go in that orangey box, which is like an Iron Fist shoebox. And then once that box is full, it'll be put into another box and goes into the cupboard. In case you're wondering about the cupboard, that unit there is on wheels, so if I need to get into the cupboard, I can just wheel that aside, just in case you were curious. This very attractive lime green shoebox is going to be flipbook storage. Some of the flipbooks have been stored in other places before I just came up with this idea, like, last night. But I need to make dividers for this, so each flipbook pal gets their own little section, so that's very early stages of that. These two like magazine file things, I'll pull these out to show you. Ugh. So this holds A4 letter writing paper, so I've got 4 of these really pretty pads from Paper Chase. And then these, when I said earlier about a notebook I was going to dismantle, this is what I meant. So you get these notebooks from Wilko often that have got like really nice paper inside, so I uncoil them and use them as letter writing paper. And then when I write a letter, I just like slice off the bit where the coils went into. And there's some more stuff that I've uncoiled in there. So that was like some nice grid paper, and that was a cat notebook. And all the paper is like this little cat face. So I uncoil these things and actually use them as letter writing paper, because I think they're falling over, way more useful that way. And then this one is also letter writing paper, so various bits and bobs in here. Back here is a load of postcards and cards, and this front section here is a massive wad of these really nice just blank greetings cards that you get from the works, and they're like $1.99 a pack, and they're also on buy one get one free, so I just have a ton of these. I have the kitten ones because, you know, obviously. And down here are some mini cards and things like that's just handy in there. And then this box here I got from Sainsbury's about a year ago. It was on offer for £4, I think. It's a big good plastic box. I've just realised if I open this, it may not be good. Basically, this is my gift box and Happy Mail box. This is full of things that are nice bits that I'm going to send to people or use in giveaways and things like that. I'm just going to open it first because I think something on the very top is for someone and they will very probably be watching this video. So I'm just going to open it first to just to check what's inside. I've taken that stuff out. But so yeah, here is just loads and loads of bits that I either pick up on purpose or stuff that, you know, I've decided I might not use. Just all sorts of bits in there. There's ephemera packs, to-do list, sticky notes, just loads and loads of stuff that are for giving away, basically. So it's my gift box. There's a bunch of stuff in here that I'm going to be doing for my future giveaway, which will hopefully happen in the next couple of weeks. So stick around for that if you are interested. To my dears, we are on the home stretch. So we're going from there to there. There is my printer sitting on top of this little bamboo coffee table, which again, something I already had. The printer is Canon Pixma MG something, something, something. I don't know. It prints double-sided automatically, so I like it. On top of there is a laminator as well. Underneath this table, you probably can't see or only just see, it's just a ream of 80 GSM paper for like printing off for uni notes and stuff, because I don't want to really use my really nice quality paper if it's just my rubbishy notes. You see the paint job here is particularly good. So the last thing to show you here is my sort of like arty and printing area. So I'll get down on the floor first to show you what's underneath. So underneath here, I've got this little plastic drawer unit, aimlessly stolen from my dad's office. But these things you can get everywhere, you know. At the top here, I've got my Copic marker pad. And then in the drawers, so the first drawer has got laminating stuff in. So those are like some little mini laminating sheets. Those are laminating cutoffs, which I can use for personal size. And there's two things of laminating pouches in there. This drawer has printer paper, so you see I've divided it into 100 GSM is underneath there and 120 GSM here. In this drawer I have, just find the thing, thin card, so between 150 and 200 GSM down there. Oh, with some photo printing paper down there as well. And then thick card, super thick white card there. And in the top drawer, I have sticker paper. So I've got like label sticker paper, and then I've got proper A4 sticker paper there as well. And there's a spare printer cartridge, just so it's handy. Oh, I nearly forgot down here. That's not very exciting. It's chalk tool, which has got a load of those plastic dividers that I used in there. In case I need to use some more of them. Then I've got these two boxes here. This box has got current projects in, so I kind of hide them with this blanket. The blanket I also use because sometimes it gets really cold in here in the evening, so I sit there with my blanket around me. But in here is some stuff I need to work on, so these boxes are all going to be painted up and personalised as Christmas presents for people, and that's something I need to make a copy of by way of painting a copy of it, not just making a copy with a printer. So they're partially hidden just in case someone comes in here and might see them. Box. Only has a couple of bits in at the moment. I've got two glue guns because my dad found one and he doesn't use it, so he gave me this one, which is like a proper like scary one, big one that, you know, probably cost a lot originally. And then I've got my cool hobbycraft one there. Spare glue sticks, and I've got some art stencils in here as well. Also down here I've just got like this little mini bin, which I had something, again, I already had. It's actually a plant pot, I think, but it's just for my laziness really. So if I'm over here and need to use a bin, I just put it in there, and then I take this one to the bigger one and empty out in there. You know, how to be a lazy crafter 101. So up here is my arty area. Just put my laptop down a bit so it's not too distracting. It's been playing music earlier, so that's why it's there. This table was in my little brother's room and he didn't want it anymore, so I was like, yes please. And so, because this was from IKEA years and years ago and cost like a tenner or something, and so it really doesn't matter if I get paint all over it. There is a matching chair for it actually, which is in the next room at the moment. I just use the same chair and scoot around on it, but I've got the other chair just in case like my cat falls asleep on this one or something, or if I have someone else in the room, you know. So up on the wall here, I've just got some colour charts. So I've got like pencil ones here. Most importantly, I've got my Copic marker chart. So obviously the ones that are coloured in are the colours I already have. I use Copic Chow, not Copic Sketch, because, you know, I'm poor. So the ones you see with black dots in are the colours that I don't have that are also available in Chow. The rest of the colours that aren't there are ones that are only available in Sketch, so yes, that's what's going on there. And then there is the various felt tip colour charts there, and they also cover up a particularly bad bit of pen work as well. So here, that's just like a current project. As you see, I've lost the light. I did try and start early, but you know, it hates me. That's also partially up because it's covering up something particularly dodgy in the room that needs fixing, and I don't want to show you because it's embarrassing. So I don't usually cover up the light with that, but seeing as I've lost it now anyway, I didn't think it mattered if I put that up there. I'll put that aside for now to show you my pens and stuff. So I've got another lamp there. I want a whiteboard up there just for notes to self. And you see, my lamps are very, very practical rather than pretty, but they're ones that you can really, really adjust to spotlight exactly where you want them, so I really like them. Both shamelessly stolen from my dad, I'm afraid. I can't tell you where they're from. All of these pen pots here are from Wellco, and were like a pound or a pound 50 each. So this one has all the coloured pencils in, these ones are the watercolour ones, and these ones are just standard. This has all my Stabilo 68 felt tips. This one has fine liners, so the Stabilo 88s and the Sharpie Ultra Fines. This one is various things. So I've got a pair of scissors, some fine liners in different sizes, some of those fine gel pens, some of my novelty pens as well in there, some like sparkly pipe cleaner things. I've got my two history rulers, you know, my ruler of rulers and my Viking history ruler. Very handy these were at uni, trying to remember things like that basic stuff that most history students should know and I can never ever remember. These two pen pots, mugs actually, are mugs that are like kind of special to me, but can't actually be used for liquids anymore because they're like cracked and liquids leak out. That was from when the first Harry Potter movie came out when I was like 11, so aww. And I have my sketching pencils of various softness in there, and I've also got these flags that I picked up from the conference I worked at a while back. And I got the flag, we had them decorating tables, and I got the flags of like the countries I'm most obsessed with, apart from Iceland, because someone already stole that one before I could get to it, but these are the countries I'm obsessed with, and I've only been to one of them, which is Germany, but anyway. And then this one was a graduation present mug, which my dad broke, and this has my paint brushes in, and a spongy paintbrush thing, and some tissues. I don't have many paint brushes, as you see, but even with these, there's only actually a couple of them I actually use frequently, which is basically that one. But yeah, I mostly use my Copics, so I mostly do backgrounds and paints. Just quickly, in this little box here, another one from Wellco. These, I know I've said that so much, but they're really cheap and they're really sturdy, so they're great. I've just got some like functional bits, like I've got these surface wipes just because, you know, I make a mess. I got these two super large clips, which are really useful if you're doing like an art journal and you need, and it's in a notebook and you need to keep the notebook held open. Just got a little cute little cow sharpener. There's an eraser in here somewhere, eraser, and a little memo pad because I have these everywhere. And this box is currently empty at the moment, but I'm sure it will be filled with something useful at some point. And then the very last thing, as you see, we're getting to the dodgy covered up corner now. So you're just getting a snippet of that. So this is my sort of like art trolley. This was a DVD thing. So it's like a spinning DVD rack. I've also decluttered. I've decluttered a lot in my room, and I got rid of all of my DVDs because I just don't use them. I watch everything online, you know, I download it, or I've got everything, you know, on an external hard drive. So DVDs are just pointless for me to have. They just take up space. So I got rid of them and repurposed this as a little art trolley, and I'm pretty actually quite pleased with how it's turned out. At the top here, both of these cups are for, you know, water, for dipping paintbrushes in and cleaning them and stuff. This I got around Halloween, I can't remember where from, possibly Wilco, for like 50p, just because, as you might know, I'm into spooky Halloween stuff, so I got that one. If you are of a sensitive or easily offended disposition, look away now. And yeah, this is my other favourite mug, because I like grammar. So some of my very good friends need to read this. You guys know who you are. But yeah, so I use that as well, because people get a little bit too offended if I have this as an actual tea mug, so I use it for paintbrushes. You can look back now if you looked away. And then here I have all of my Copic Chow markers. I know people tend to look down their nose at Copic Chow because, you know, it's more in to have Copic Sketch, but quite frankly, Copic Chow are exactly the same thing, they're just smaller. They've got the same nibs, it's the same ink, they're just cheaper and smaller. And Sketch, I mean, these cost, I won't tell you how much I bought them for because I got some really, really good bargains. Which, to be fair, I can't really remember because I've had one of these for years and one of them this month for about a year. But they are worth about £200 each, so even Chow are expensive, and Sketch are double the price. I just can't afford that, I'm afraid. I can barely afford these. These were treats to myself, but there's my Copic markers. So I've got 272 sets, which means I need 36 more Chow colours to have all of them. So up on this top shelf of my little spinning thing here, this was one of those sweet shop things you get at Christmas, and I keep all my acrylic paints in there, and I also have some PVA glue and some modelling paste in there. So there's most of the acrylic paints are in there as well, but when you turn around, I also have some really, really big tubs of acrylic paints. So, you know, I've got a big white, two big blacks for some reason, I don't know why, thing of gesso and some acrylics. They're in these particular colours because they were bought for a project. So that's why I just have kind of have reds and yellows instead of all of the colours. And then back to the other side, this shelf here, it's another one of those Christmas tins actually. This like was one of my nieces or something, it's a Disney princess one, and I keep watercolours in there. I'm not a big watercolourer, I really prefer acrylics, so I haven't got much. I've just got a palette, I've got a palette and some tubes. I do want another palette that I've put on my Christmas wish list. We shall see if I get it. And down here, I'm sorry it's so dark, I'll try and pull stuff out, but this is mostly just papers and stuff, so I've got some watercolour postcards that you can paint yourself. This is my art tear off palette, because I've yet to find a proper paint palette that I actually like. Some more watercolour papers, I've got some more like graded sketch pencils. The reason I have two packs is because I lost one for a while, so just gave up and bought another one, and then of course 5 seconds later found the original, so I can't remember which way around is the original or not, but I've got plenty of those to last me. More watercolour paper in there. There's a load of like current projects and stuff I'm working on with Copic markers, and there's some watercolour paper there, a sketchbook there, and an old watercolour pad there. So lots and lots of paper, painting paper and stuff to use in there. So there we go, guys, that was my craft room. I hope you enjoyed. I hope it wasn't too long. Actually saying that, it probably was. I've been at this for ages filming, and I don't know how much footage I've got, so it probably was ages long. So congratulations if you've made it all the way through. If I've forgotten something, like if I just like glanced over something or skipped over it really quickly, then let me know. Like if you want to see anything in more detail, or if I've missed something really, really obvious, just let me know. Just type down in the comments, Grace, you're an idiot, I need to know the answer to X. So I don't mind, call me an idiot, I don't care.
But yes, there we go. There is the craft room. So hopefully in, who knows how long it's going to take, 6 months to a year, I would say, that corner up there will be fixed. And what is also over there that is completely unusable at the moment because of the water damage, but built-in shelves and a built-in cupboard and stuff, which will obviously be really, really useful when I can actually use it. So hopefully I can show you that. And I'm obviously probably my collection will have increased and this will be painted and it might be interesting to see how stuff has changed. So yeah, there we go. But for now, this is my space, and it may not be to everyone's taste, but I love it. I'm very happy in here. I'm not a matching furniture kind of person. So yeah, there we go. Thank you so, so much for watching. And as I said, questions, do let me know, because I really probably have missed out some really obvious stuff. And yeah, right, that's enough rambling from me. I'm gonna go. Yeah, okay. Bye!